Okay, good evening. Today we are going to be discussing the hierarchy of control. So the hierarchy of control, whether you are doing a diploma or you are doing a certificate, this approach is going to assist you in a number of ways. So basically, most of the people, they underestimate the hierarchy of control. Not knowing that, you know, under the hierarchy of control, this is where all the control measures normally, you know, emanate from. All the precautions that you can actually talk of, they actually emanate from the, you know, hierarchy of control. So we need to try and, you know, unpack the hierarchy of control and see how we can actually use the hierarchy of control. Yes, I believe we all know the hierarchy of control, where we start with elimination, substitution, engineering, administrative, and PPE. So what exactly are we saying if we say, you know, eliminate? If you are given a problem or a situation that needs, you know, our control. When we say eliminate, elimination, it means, you know, total removal. You get it? Total removal. Let's say, for example, it is a generator that is actually making noise. And if we say, you know, elimination, we are saying, let us totally remove the generator, because the generator is actually making noise. Or if it's the same machinery or generator that is actually releasing, producing some fumes, or a certain chemical that is probably causing some, you know, skin dermatitis, we will say if we remove it totally, this means it's actual elimination, total removal. You get it? But normally, the total elimination of a certain problem is not feasible in most cases. Because if we eliminate completely and not, you know, replace it with something, it means that process, that project will then cease. You get it? So in most cases, the elimination is not feasible. And if it's not feasible, the next option will be substitution. No wonder why we always say elimination by substitution. We'll then go to the substitution. So most students, most people, they tend to confuse between elimination and substitution. You get it? These are two different things. Where when we talk of elimination, like what I've indicated, we are totally removing it. We get it. But when it comes to the substitution, substitution, it means we are actually replacing it. You get it. If it's a generator that is generating noise, you get it, producing noise, making noise. If we substitute, we are saying, this generator, do we have another generator that is going to perform the same function, but with less or no noise at all? It means we have substituted the one that is actually making noise. Or we can say the source of power is from generator, but it is actually making noise and producing some fumes. What can we do? Let us probably, in producing the solar system, we have substituted the generator with a solar system. You get it? So it means we are actually replacing it. It's not total removal of everything. We are actually replacing it with something. You get it? This is elimination. And then when it comes to engineering controls, there are situations whereby, number one, it's not feasible for us to eliminate a certain item that might be causing a certain problem. Number two, because of its function, we cannot again substitute it. Probably that one is actually the best, and we cannot substitute it with another thing. So what are we going to do? We'll then go on to the engineering. You get it? Where, depending with the nature of the problem, the nature of the hazard, we'll then try to introduce some, you know, engineering measures. Let's say again it is maybe a generator, it which is actually making noise. Yeah. But because all these two are not feasible, we'll then try to put some engineering, you know, control measures, like probably putting, you know, some silencers, putting a housing, putting some noise, you know, dampeners, you know, to try and minimize, you know, or probably remove the hazard. So this is what engineering, you know, control measures. We are trying to put some, you know, some technical, you know, innovation in order to make sure that we have actually minimized this this problem. So we'll then use the engineering controls. And then we'll then go on to the, you know, administrative controls. We are going to, you know, deal with this administrative control in detail at a later stage. But it's actually, you know, one of the, you know, control measures where, yes, we can actually try to put this, but if we do not use the administrative, you know, control, you see that probably the problem might also be, there. There are situations whereby probably these things have been tried, have been tested, but still, we still have a problem. We will then go to the, you know, administrative control measures. And then last but not least, we will then go to the PPE, personal protective clothing or equipment. This is where we say, after, you know, trying all these control measures, but the problem is still there, we will then resort to the personal protective, you know, personal protective clothing or equipment. In most cases, it's actually meant to deal with, you know, some of the risky. That will be probably the residual risky, you get it, or probably the tolerable risky, where you say, you know what, I think we can probably do with this problem, but what can we do? We need to put some, you know, personal protective, you know, clothing or equipment. In some situation, you will be asked to say, why is, you know, PPE the last line of defense, you get it? In order for you to be able to attempt it, in order for you to be able to handle this, you need to understand this, you get it? So now, what are we saying? If we say, if you master the hierarchy of control, it means you are able to answer most of the questions that will require you to put some control measures in place. If you know this hierarchy of control, believe me, you will not, you know, experience, you know, challenges in as far as the question that, you know, demand you to be, you know, writing the control measures are actually concerned. For example, let's talk of baby noise, vibration, radiation, dust. You know, these are different, you know, problems that might demand the control measures. But if you know the hierarchy of control, you are able to articulate. For example, whether it's noise, whether it's radiation, whether it's vibration, you get it, whether it's light, we can still implement this elimination. To say no, if it's radiation, let us eliminate. Though in most cases, it might not be feasible. You get it? Whether it's noise, this still applies. You get it? This still applies to say we can probably eliminate that thing that is actually causing us that problem. You get it? And then we go on to the substitution. Substitution, it also applies again. You get it? From whatever the angle. Whether it's vibration again, noise again, radiation again, we can also say, we can actually, you know, substitute that thing that is actually, you know, causing the problem. Whether it's a generator, whether it's a vibrating machine, we can as well still use the substitution as what? As a control. The only point where the answer, in as far as the hierarchy of control is concerned, would differ depending on the nature of the problem, will be the engineering. The engineering controls are not the same. The engineering controls, they vary depending with the nature of the problem. That is, you cannot use the engineering controls of noise, on vibration, on dust, on light. So this is a situation where you need to understand the subject matter that you are actually dealing with. You get it? You need to understand the subject matter that you are actually dealing with. Which means there are engineering control measures that are there for a specific, you know, situation. But then that one is not a problem. You might be faced with a situation whereby maybe you are not, you know, well versed with the engineering controls. This is where we will then call upon the administrative. The administrative, this is the master, this is the killer, you get it? Even if you do not understand the subject that you are dealing with, even if you do not understand the control measures of probably noise, the control measures of probably radiation, the control measures of probably vibration, the control measures of probably light, of probably heat, but if you understand the administrative control measures, you are able to articulate any question that requires you to outline the control measures. You get it? So what are we saying? We now need to unpack the administrative, because the administrative angle, this is where it will actually make the life easy. You get it? Whether you are writing a certificate or a diploma, if you are able to unpack the administrative, you know, section, you are able to articulate each and every, you know, question. Unless otherwise, that question specifies to say they need the engineering controls. Was there a situation whereby you'd be asked the engineering controls, or there are situation whereby you'd be asked probably the administrative controls? You get it? So it is actually very, 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 very important to understand the administrative control measures. So we need to unpack the administrative control measures. If you are able to unpack the administrative control measures, then you are actually in a better position to articulate each and every question. What are we saying? If we are saying the administrative control measures is actually applicable across the board, whatever the problem that needs you to apply, that need you to put the control measures, if you know the administrative, then you are actually okay. What are examples of administrative? We are saying training. Hazard identification and risk assessment. You get it? Job rotation. Frequent breaks. Duration of work. Police. Procedures. And standards, operating procedures. Inspection. Medicals. Supervision. What else? Yes, so these are some of the administrative control measures, and there are other administrative control measures. So let us look into different, you know, scenarios and see if what you are saying to say this is applicable across is correct. For example, we are talking of noise, and we need the control measures of noise. Training, we need to train people about the hazards and risk associated with noise. We need to do risk assessment. We need to do job rotation for the people who are actually exposed to noise. We need to do some frequent breaks for the people who are actually exposed to noise. We can also reduce the, you know, the exposure time, the duration, to the people who are actually exposed to noise. We can actually also make a noise policy, develop a noise policy. Also, the procedures for the people who are actually exposed to noise, operating procedures. inspection of the machineries that are actually generating the noise, medicals to examine the people who are going to be working in a noise environment, supervision to also supervise. So these are the administrative control. We are actually trying to talk of noise. The same answer also applies to vibration. You get it? To say the people are actually exposed to vibration, we can also train them. We can also do a risk assessment, job rotation, frequent breaks, duration, policy, procedures, inspection, medical supervision, radiation. The same answer again, you know, applies. The people who are probably exposed to dust, the same answer also applies. People who are exposed to extreme temperatures, whether it's cold or whether it's hot, the same answer also applies. So whether you're doing a certificate or you're doing a diploma, if you are able to unpack the administrative controls, you get it? You are able to articulate any question that requires you to outline the control measures. Only if that question specifies to say they need the engineering controls. But if it's not about engineering, if it's about only the control measures, then this, you know, answer, it's actually dynamic. We are saying it's fit for all. Any question that requires you, you are actually able to use this one as an answer to answer any question that requires you to outline, to identify, to give or to state the control measures. You get it? All what you need to do is to be able to unpack the administrative control. So, having said this, I think I've done, you know, justice. Whether you are doing a certificate or a diploma, this part will enable you, will assist you to prepare for, you know, any question that requires you to provide them with the control measures. Thank you.